It's said that those who will not learn from history's lessons are doomed to repeat its mistakes. So what hope then can the future possibly have if the history of the world is erased? Hi, I'm Brian Pope. I'm the executive director and founder of the ARC Project. The ARC Project is a nonprofit that I founded in the hopes of preserving, protecting, archiving, and restoring cultural heritage wherever it was endangered. People have asked us, why Palmyra? For over 1,000 years, it was a truly multicultural society that tolerated differences in race, religion, and language.
Palmyra was a major crossroads for goods, ideas. It allowed for all of these different cultures to interact. In fact, they had to interact in order for it to even exist.
More than 3,000 years of history obliterated in seconds.
ISIS has released new pictures showing destruction in the ancient city of Palmyra in Syria.
ISIS is taking a hammer to history.
You know, there comes a point at which the personal outrage that you feel reading these headlines, one after the other, simply becomes too much. And that's what it was like for me. It was almost an epiphany. You know, I just suddenly realized that not only was I capable of doing something about this, I sort of felt that I had to. And to some degree, I think that all of us are obligated to do something about this. One of the aspects of what we've achieved that I'm most proud of is the concept of crowdsourced photogrammetry.
So photogrammetry is the process of taking multiple images, often thousands of images, of a given object or environment. From these images, you can recreate that object or environment. You're ultimately using your camera as a 3D scanner.
We realized that you could, you know, take different pictures from a completely different point in time and recreate something that doesn't exist anymore.
I realized that sort of the missing link was human involvement, individual citizen involvement.
What we did is went online to different image source sites and found people that had posted Creative Commons images that we could download of these specific sites and then reproject the textures from those images that we collected back onto the model itself to make it look as photorealistic as possible.
Once a 3D model is created, then the ARC Project's job is to proselytize that culture, communicate about it in such a way that it can be used for education, for artistic enjoyment, and experienced through other groundbreaking, awesome, incredible technologies that are changing our lives right now, like virtual reality and augmented reality. We're using these technologies not just for games now, but organizations like mine, I'm really, really proud to say, are at the forefront of doing something beautiful with our work in VR. To communicate, to educate, and even to activate.
We're able to actually capture you know, details of the different carvings on it and tile structures. So to go into virtual reality and walk around it, I always kind of get the tingles when I go in there, just because it's bittersweet, ultimately, because it's not there anymore, and yet it's right in front of me.
It's pretty much uniform that having experienced walking on the stones of a dead but hopefully reborn site that represents some of humanity's greatest moments, people just get charged up. They want to do something.
So when we embarked about a year ago to preserve Palmyra, we never knew that we would be able to take it as far as we have. But we realized how much further we have to go.
One of the major points behind doing a version 2 of Palmyra is to generate a level of detail that is so fine, so exacting, that should the World Heritage community decide to rebuild Palmyra at some point in the future, whenever this horrible war is over, and that culture is able to begin healing, this level of detail would allow archaeologists and restorers to regenerate Palmyra, to replace at least some of what ISIS tried to destroy.
We want to put this in the hands of everybody, and we find that photogrammetry is a way of doing that.
If we can experience our own history as if it were happening yesterday, then we won't forget it. And then history's lessons become infinitely more valuable. And that's when the future starts to look bright. At least that's our hope. And that's our mission. And we could use some help.